Hi friends, it's me, Laura, and I'm so excited to welcome you to Base Camp today. Parents, it's our mission to support you in reaching your child's heart for Christ. And today, we can't wait for your family to hear more from our series all about trusting that God has a plan. In just a moment, we'll visit Ollie the Owl and our clubhouse friends to hear today's amazing true Bible story. Last week, we left off with Joseph stuck in jail. Oh no! I wonder what the next part of God's plan for Joseph will be. But before we find out, it's time to worship God together. So go ahead, stand up, and get ready to dance.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
He's got a plan for me. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
No matter what the season.
Yeah.
His plans are for a reason.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because he said
he's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me.
That's what I know. And when I'm feeling so sad, hey, when I am afraid, God will never leave me. No, 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 His love will never change. I know they are good. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because I said
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
My eyes and ears and mouth and nose. He loves.
friend in Jesus. He loves everything about me. Oh, I've got a friend.
It is
time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down to the clubhouse where wonder never ends at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Meet him
at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Meet him.
Friends, welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Kai. I'm so glad you're all here today. I was getting ready for the big ice cream sundae party at the clubhouse. These pictures are a step-by-step plan on how to make the most fantastic, most spectacular, most yummiest to the tummiest ice cream sundae ever. Step one, you get a bowl, a spoon, and a napkin, then you're ready to make an ice cream sundae. Step two, add ice cream to the bowl. It can be any kind of ice cream you want. Step three, add the toppings. Ice cream sundaes need lots of toppings. Step four, and what's the last thing we do with our ice cream sundae? We eat it. What a great plan.
Hoo, hoo.
It's Ollie.
Hello, Kai. Hoo, hoo. What are you up to?
Hi, Ollie. Well, I just finished putting together my plan to make the perfect ice cream sundae.
Yes, that is an excellent plan. It's true. I have a story about another great plan for you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through.
Casey, and I'm helping out at the cupcake food truck. Do you want to see my latest, most delicious creation? Ta-da! These are my sweet dreams cupcakes, because in today's story, we're going to talk about someone who had some pretty amazing dreams. If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, tell me a story. One, two, three! Tell me a story! Woo! This is Joseph. He was put in jail, even though he had done nothing wrong. Being in jail was hard for Joseph, but God had a different plan. One day, the king of all of Egypt, the Pharaoh, had some dreams he didn't understand. They were about seven cows. Cows? What do cows say? Moo! You're right. Dreaming about cows is funny. Wait, ooh, let's count the cows in Pharaoh's dream. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven! Great job! Seven cows. The Pharaoh also dreamed about stalks of grain. Grain? We make bread out of grain. Let's pretend to have a snack. Yum. Yum! Pharaoh wanted to know what his dreams meant. And drum roll, please. He asked Joseph to help him. Hooray! Joseph was brought out of jail straight to the Pharaoh. He told Pharaoh that the dreams were from God. that Pharaoh needed to save lots and lots of grain because his people were going to be hungry and need it later. Pharaoh was so happy to know what his dreams meant that he gave Joseph a very special job. He put Joseph in charge of all of Egypt. Years later, the dreams came true. People were hungry and didn't have food, so they traveled from all over to get grain from Joseph. Wow! God's plan was for Joseph to help all these people. God has a plan for us too. And God's plan is the best plan. Did you like the story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up! Hey, Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. Joseph followed God's plan, and we should too.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Who? Who?
Wow, I loved that story. Joseph followed God's plan and helped so many people. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say, got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. I'm excited about following this plan. It's going to be delicious. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.
Wow, that's pretty amazing that God used Joseph to help all of those people. It's so good to remember that God always has a plan, and his plan is always good and for our good. God has a plan for me, and God has a plan for you. Now, before we get going, will you say our memory verse with me? Ready? For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. That was so great. Okay, let's pray. Dear God, thank you that you have a plan and that your plan is always good. Help us to trust and follow you. We love you. Amen. Thanks again for joining us. We'll see you next time.